guys, GPUs have come a long way from just gaming. If you're looking for a new GPU or even a complete PC, now whether that's for smoother video editing, faster 3D renders, or building next-gen AI models, chances are you need a good GPU. And by good, I mean it should work for your particular application. But NVIDIA has more than 30 plus models in their entire lineup of GPUs. So which one is the best for you? And to answer that, you're going to explore three categories of NVIDIA GPUs and all their use cases.
डैड मैं शूट कर रहा हूँ, मैं दो मिनट दे दो, दो शूट कर रहा हूँ, दो मिनट दे दो भाई.
स्टार्टिंग विथ द GeForce सीरीज, विच इज स्पेसिफिकली डिजाइन फॉर गेमिंग पर्पसेस, बट कैन ऑल्सो हैंडल मोस्ट प्रोडक्टिविटी टास्क. द क्वाड्रो सीरीज, विच इज स्पेसिफिकली बिल्ड फॉर क्रिएटिव प्रोफेशनल्स इन कंटेंट क्रिएशन, 3D डिजाइन एंड आर्किटेक्चर. एंड फाइनली वी हैव द डेटा सेटर सीरीज, एंड दिस पावर्स ऑल द लेटेस्ट एंड ग्रेटेस्ट, नेमली जनरेटिव AI एंड हाई परफॉर्मेंस कंप्यूट. Starting off with the GeForce series, which is further divided into two categories, GTX and RTX. While the GTX is kind of getting end of life and getting discontinued across the board, it can still deliver some good performance for 1080p gaming. It's a go-to for most entry-level gamers and even content creators. So if you're a young student or someone who's just starting out with gaming or content creation, this is a solid choice. Coming to RTX, which is the newer generation of gaming GPUs, the reason why modern games look photorealistic. It has dedicated RT cores which create realistic lighting, shadows, and reflections, allowing games and 3D applications to render photorealistic images in real time. And before we move ahead, let's quickly understand the naming of these GPUs. Now, the first two numbers denote the generation, and naturally, the bigger the number, the newer the generation of the GPU. So as of now, 40 series is the latest gen of GeForce GPUs. And in the 40 series, we have many different tiers. 4060, 4070, up until 4090, which is the highest end variant. And then we have the TI and Super variants. Yes, we know it can get super confusing. TI got Ti bolte hain waise.
The GeForce RTX 3080 Ti, the 80 Ti, 1080 Ti, 2080 Ti.
So in the interest of saving everyone's time, you can check out this table for recommendations for all use cases. Now moving on to the next series, the Quadro GPUs. Now we know the term Quadro has been discontinued by NVIDIA and has been replaced by calling them professional GPU. But for the sake of understanding and ease of reference, let's call them Quadro once again. And you can think of Quadro series as a big brother to the GeForce series. They have similar specs as well as similar performance. But unlike their GeForce counterparts, the Quadros are purpose-built for professional workflows, which means render crashes, hardware bugs, driver issues become irrelevant on these Quadro workstations, as they are tested and certified by NVIDIA themselves to run 24/7 at peak performance without failure. GeForce GPUs, on the other hand, do not get this testing and validation, leaving a good margin for error and failure. Quadro GPUs have similar performance like their GeForce counterparts while being very power efficient. Like the Quadro A6000, for example, provides RTX 3090 level throughput while consuming 30% less power. Now imagine having 10 Quadro cards in a render farm. These savings over GeForce GPUs dramatically reduce operation costs over years of usage. Another advantage is larger and more secure memory. Quadro GPUs usually come with 2x more VRAM, ECC memory, error correction code for those who didn't know, allowing you extra legroom in large projects while also preventing data corruption. So you can check this table for our recommendations. So if you're into 3D or content creation professionally and cannot afford to lose time, a professional or Quadro series can come in real handy. Now finally, moving to data center GPUs, these are mainly for enterprises who are looking for large scale solutions, otherwise known as having too much money. So to give you some context, if you are an individual who specializes in 3D rendering, you would go for the professional or Quadro series of GPUs for your workstation. But if you have a team of 3D designers, you could go for a data center GPU and a server and split them across the team. Basically, data center GPUs are built for more flexibility and scalability, which is really important for larger teams. Last but not least, these GPUs are built to make AI applications like generative AI. The latest GPUs in the data center lineup, like the L40S, have something called a transformer engine. Iske baare mein kaafi bola hai dusre video mein, so we'll not repeat us. So that was all about these GPUs, divided in three different categories. So I hope you understand this a little better. And in case you're looking to build your system with any kind of GPU, you can get in touch with us. We make workstations, we make servers, and we do make amazing gaming machines as well. Thank you for watching. Until next time, cheers. हो गया।